Hello and welcome to the first part of our cosplay armor tutorial series. In this part, we will show you how you can create a pattern for a piece of armor. As a practical example, we show the production of a pattern for a bracer. The following things are needed to produce an armor pattern: cling film, masking tape, a scissor, a pen, a sheet of paper, oh, and of course, a body part. In this tutorial, we additionally use bubble wrap because our bracer should partially be loose. What does loose mean? Two of the most common types of armor are direct pieces of armor, which were applied directly to the body, and loose pieces of armor that at least partly have some room between the armor piece and the body. Our bracer should not rest on the back of the hand so that the wrist can still be moved naturally. In order to have enough space between the back of the hand and the bracer, we fix some bubble wrap as a spacer. Alternatively, you can also use handkerchiefs or something similar. If you want to build a piece of armor which rests entirely on the body, you can omit this step. During the next step, cover the whole area where the armor is intended to be with cling film. This will be the base of your pattern. Inherently, cling film has no reputation for being breathable. So never, never, never cover mouth or nose with it. After the cling film, let's say prison, is finished, put stripes of masking film on it. Now you can draw the form of your bracer directly on the masking tape. When you are satisfied with your work, carefully free the body out of the cling film prison. Neither fabrics nor skin should be damaged if possible. Now, the shape of the armor part is cut along the drawn lines. The cutout shape is transferred onto a sheet of paper. As you can see, we transferred only half the shape on the paper. We noticed that we were not able to draw the shape totally symmetrically on the masking tape. Because we fold the sheet of paper at the half of the shape and then cut it out, we now get a really symmetrically armor pattern. If you manage to draw the shape of the armor symmetrically on the masking tape, you don't need that trick. We like to apply our pattern also to a more stable paper. This makes it much more durable. If you like, you can transfer the shape directly on thicker paper, which saves you one step. Keep your pattern and don't throw them away after finishing a project. You never know, maybe you need them again for another. Well, that was the first part of our cosplay armor tutorial series. Sorry for horrible pronunciation, school is a long time ago. We hope we could deliver some interesting information and advice for you. In the next part, we will deal with how you can build a warbler bracer from the finished pattern. Ciao, and perhaps until next video of this series.